January the 20th, today's wisdom, deviations of wine dependency. Wine is a mocker, strong drink is raging, and whosoever is deceived thereby is not wise. Proverbs 20:1. In this verse, the wise man warns against wine dependency. Alcohol or wine dependency dates way back in human history. Let's keep in mind it is progressively destructive on the brain, liver, and kidneys, but also ruined families and nations worldwide. Noah was the first person to ever discover dependency to wine, Genesis 9:20-21. The Bible says, "And Noah awoke from his wine, and knew what his younger son had done unto him. And he said, Cursed be Canaan, a servant of servants shall he be unto his brethren." Genesis 9:24. How tragic. However, the mandate given to man and woman by God is to expand life on earth, not only with babies and especially not with curses, but with his image. Genesis 1:26. Now, because of wine, cursed people will be found all over the earth. Jesus says, "I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly." John 10:10. That is to say that it is definitely possible to recover life as Jesus Christ intended and not in alcohol. Despite their fruitful devotion to God, wine dependency has remained a tough challenge to the Ephesians, reason why Paul urged them to be filled with the Holy Spirit instead of wine, Ephesians 5:18. What is an ongoing challenge to you? To be responsible, pastor, elder, deacon, chorister, in God's church, one of the substantial criteria is not to be addicted to wine, 1 Timothy 3:3. According to this criterion, are we eligible? If we lack finding dependency to Christ and to His Word, then we will turn to other things to fill the hole, whether it be anger, money, sex, fright, work, food, wine, and so on. Jesus said, "But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life." John 4:40. Jesus says that for the Holy Spirit should be given to the recipients of the Word of God to durably quench their need of love, joy, and peace. Truth, the Holy Spirit by Himself provides love, joy, peace for eternity to those who receive the Word of God. Application: take in the Word of God, reflect on it every day, and ask God to fill me with His Spirit so that I walk according to His will. Recommendation: as newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the Word, that ye may grow thereby. 1 Peter 2:2. Let's pray together. Father, fill me with your Word continuously, and help me to always be filled with the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. Today's reading: Psalm 96-100, Proverbs 20, Exodus 7-9. You are blessed.